ーい。
Hey everybody, it's me, Pumpkin Potion, Bazinga, you know my classic catchphrase. Steve Hornsby, thank you so much for subscribing to the, my stream, which is Pumpkin Potion stream. You know, I'm not Pumpkin Potion, you guys. How's everybody doing? Well, now I'm T-Pose, that's how I know Captain Steel Pants is here. Hi, Captain Steel Pants. Yep. No, because you know... Pumpkin Potion invented black and white mode. Nah, I'm kidding. She just stole it from Bendy and the Ink Machine. Let's take a look at your little slimes. There's so many cool people here. There's Steez Hornsby. There's Noodle Cat Does Things. There's Monochrome TV. There's Cabin Steel Pants. There's Dead Sun Prime. I'm gonna shout out Steez Hornsby because we don't get to do that as often as I would like. There you go, you shall follow Steez Hornsby. Steez Hornsby is a very cool, like, goblin lich tuber, very much in the same kind of fantasy, like, realm that me and a lot of my friends are in. Very fun dude, very charming, doing some really cool stuff in Unreal Engine, and yeah, I strongly recommend it. I've got to support her fellow liches. Let's see. Monochrome TV says, I actually invented black and white as a color scheme before everyone else. Oh, boy. Favorite controller? Yeah, we're gonna be doing some 3D modeling tonight. We made... Oh, colors returned to the world. Okay, so... Off air, I finished that little TV back there. It's a little, like, DVD television combo / iMac / Dreamcast thing. That's going to be our... Yeah, Slimecast, absolutely. That's going to be our framing device for the Slime Quest minigame that we're gonna work on. And I'm gonna make some controllers for it. And we're gonna make a buttload of controllers. First one's a Dreamcast controller. And I have a Pure Ref open. we're gonna do a bunch of really dumb looking controllers. We're gonna do this GameCube keyboard monstrosity. We're gonna do the Saturn 3D controller. We're gonna do Hello Halo, very nice wind spell. Mercedes Web, how's it going? Yeah, we're gonna do the DK bongos. And then what else are we gonna do? We need four of them. I'm kind of torn on what we're gonna do for the fourth one. Or maybe that is four. Yeah, we have Dreamcast, we have Saturn, we have bongos, and we have keyboard monstrosity. So that's four, yeah. Other ones I was considering were like the Game Boy Advance, like link cable thing. It's oh no. My hammers are fighting with each other. Hold on, I'll do the... Oh no, there's a cooldown, isn't it? Isn't there? Well, you can kind of see them up there. yeah, we got a bunch of shitty middies at play. Yeah, I gotta go through and, like, get my camera systems to stop yelling at each other. But yeah, other ones I was considering doing was, like, that Dragon Quest slime controller, but that's a little on the nose. And then, you know, I was thinking, oh, an N-Gage or a Sidekick or a Zeebo. I don't know. Because we're just going for really bad kind of 6th, 7th generation video game nostalgia. But yeah, anyway, since we have so many cool folks here, I think, let me catch up with chat first and then we'll have a little slime race. Steez says, looking great, Fruitsy. Thank you so much. That is high praise coming from you, Steez. Let's see. Yeah, Captain Steelpants, you got scammed. Let me see if I can do the Bagman Boogie. Alright, nobody redeems slime shit for right now. There we go. There we go. There we go, little chameleon for you, or Herbie Hancock, matey. Let's see, event queue system I can send you. Yeah, Captain Steelpants, that would be very helpful if you could send that to me. Yeah, because we already have a couple of checks, like the slime redeem cam doesn't happen when we're in slime race mode. Let's see. Dead Sun Prime is thinking modeling a Game Boy, love the original design. Yeah, me too. I like the Game Boy Color, I think is a nice, like, slim version of the same idea. I had a purple Game Boy Color that I would play Link's Awakening on. Yeah, good times. Let me make sure I didn't miss anybody in chat. Okay, cool. Yeah, Dead Sun Prime invented everyone else. Yeah. 14 billion years old. DS is magical, yeah. Let's see. We do love those clamshell designs. Let me move my camera, actually. I'm not quite... Is it my... Yeah, that's close enough to eye contact. Okay. Let us go do a slime race. We're gonna go to Slime Race Island. Have ourselves a spooky race. So if you would like to compete against other slimes to win a fabulous thing for your little one to do, go ahead and type exclamation point play into chat. Your little one will be whisked away to this autumnal gauntlet. Medusa VTuber. Oh, very nice stone spell. Yeah, Carl won that in the last stream, I believe, by winning a race. See, who have we got in the field? We got... Let me... Oh, is that Space Buffoon? Hello, Space Buffoon. There's Monochrome's little one. There's Carl. There's Halo, Uwu, and Sir Pants. I guess Carl's a Ghostmancer this week. All right, we still got two more spots available, I believe. Or, let's see. Or no, wait. We got six on the... Yeah, we have two spots available. That's right. Okay. I'm going to do a countdown. Give it 10 more seconds for people to join if they would like to. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, four, three, two, one. All right, let's start though. Oh, Space Buffoon, I'll get to your question in a moment. Because right now we are starting a slime race. Boogers. Is Carl now known as Boogers? That's crude. I thought better of you, Dead Son. Space Buffoon's little one being a very sweepy boy. The frame rate is kind of weird right now. Is it? Is anyone experiencing a weird frame rate? Looks okay on my side. Okay. Yeah, maybe it's just a poor connection. Yeah, Space Buffoon. Let me know if you were referring to something else. Could be that I misunderstood the question. All right, we are going across Waterfall Bridge. Halo is taking an early lead, but things are still pretty tightened up as Archie and the Bells. No. Oh my god, Fruitsy, get your own dumb bit that nobody likes, right? Sir Pants has pulled ahead a little bit. Still anybody's race, everyone's pretty close together. I don't know any old funk songs that sound like close together, so can't do a pun for that one. Alright, Sir Pants is approaching his geyser. I also nerfed the geysers a little bit, so hopefully we won't get stun locked quite so often. Alright, Sir Pants. Oh, just narrowly not avoiding that geyser. Getting pushed back a tiny bit. Allowing Monochrome's little one to pull ahead a bit. Why is Booger so slow? Maybe you should have picked a better one. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Looks like it's between Sir Pants and Monochrome TV. Who will RNGesus bless or curse this day? Oh, looks like Sir Pants has won. Our race followed not too far behind by Monochrome TV's little one. Excellent performance. Booger's coming up from behind. There you go. Congratulations, Boogers. Trying to run a clean ship on this stream, but Dead Son just likes to push the envelope. Oh, piss. Oh, great. Yeah, thank you, Noodle Cat. Piss coming up the rear. I hate everything. Bums, you get that. You get that potty mouth out of here. It occurs to me that I don't really have a filter on what people can call their slimes. I hope we don't get any hate speech slimes. Please don't do that as a joke, everybody. Okay. Your kids told you. I'm gonna have to have a stern talking to with them. Alright, let's go to Slime Race Results Island to see what everybody won. Pee pee poo poo. Alright. Congratulations to Sir Pants for winning their first race of the evening. You're gonna get a gold feather in your crown. The Spanish Inquisition. We'll learn a little Chrono Trigger song. Monochrome will win a little Yoshi's Island song. And Sir Pants will win an extra special prize. Oh, you learned how to draw a little me! Look at that. I was wondering when somebody would win that. Yeah, it was a little sketchy avatar. Adorn my carpet with my likeness. Let's see. It's only affecting the frame rate at 1080p, so it's all good. Interesting. Oh, Monomo. That's a cool name. I like that. Reminds me of that character from Yume Nikki, that Mono girl. Yeah. That's a reference. Like, maybe three people will get. Okay, so we are going to... Wait. Quingent Tumverit. Okay. Well, I guess Noodle Cat's used to me making references of things that make no sense to her, so I guess I'm getting a little bit of my own medicine here. Okay, so we're starting off with like the hardest controller. The easiest controller would probably be the bongos because it's just two cylinders joined by a fucking cube. But, you know, why don't we start with the most difficult one, the Dreamcast controller? It's very weird shape. Government by 500 individuals. Interesting. I mostly know about JRPGs. Oh, why Soup, hello! Thank you so much for following. How's it going, why Soup? Welcome to the coven. If you are new to the channel, we got a little virtual pet system here. The first time you type in chat, a little slime boy should drop down from God knows where. Oh, I see Mecha Steel Breeder over there. Cappy, hello! Yeah, we got all kinds of things you can do to customize them and play around with them. Yeah, you can check out the About section or ask me any questions if you would like. A slimy stork. Ew. That's almost grosser than, like, the actual way that it happens. How's it going, Cabby? I have hands. Wait, hold on. Where's my other hand? Come here. Come here, hand. There you are. Ah, double waves. Okay. Ooh. Give your little one a little pat on the head. Oh, Petal, hello. How's it going? Very good to see you. There's so many cool people here today. I'm lucky to have so many cool friends. So, before we do the modeling proper, redacted. So before we start modeling it proper, I think I'm just going to, like, block out what this shape actually is. Thank you for the head pats. Constantly in awe of all the great stuff you've... Oh, thank you very much, Monochrome. That's very sweet of you. So we're going to block out what the hell the shape even is before we actually do the real modeling. Deleted by Jesus. Okay, so it has this like thing in the middle, and then we'll make a couple of cubes. Chat is much more active than I'm used to, so forgive me if I miss any of your messages. I would like to improve as a host. I've definitely gotten better, but there's always room for improvement. Yume Neki is 20 bucks on Steam. Wow. That's weird. Wait, I thought it was free. You might be thinking of the weird, like, 3D fan game that they made, which I don't recommend. Yeah, the original one should be free. This is just the RPG Maker one. Spam chat so Fruzy has no idea what's going on anymore. That's... Oh, yeah, that's on... Dream Diary is the one that you probably shouldn't play. If it's like a side-scrolling, like, Limbo knockoff, that one's no good. Yeah, I'm pretty sure the RPG Maker one's free. But yeah, the original Yume Neki is just like a really weird kind of like RPG Maker game that was kind of a walking sim before that was really like a term. You just wander around in these really trippy environments. And it's cool. You just kind of have some fun getting lost and looking at weird shit. And it was very like influential to a lot of indie developers. Because there weren't a lot of games that... There are a lot more games nowadays that are similar to it, but like at the time, there wasn't a whole lot of stuff that was like it. And you've probably heard people use its soundtrack in videos, like video essays about creepy shit. The new King Kong game. That's not a combination of words I was expecting to hear today. Is there a new movie coming out? Worse than a Wii game. Wasn't there a King Kong game for the Wii that was, like, super, like, ahead of its time in terms of game mechanics and stuff? I vaguely remember, like, people kind of doing, like, talking a lot of sugar about it in video essays. I watch a lot of video essays about video games. Because I am an adult. And I like the finer things. Yeah, it had like weird survival mechanics and like AI animals and shit. Like it had a lot of design ideas that you wouldn't see in games until a lot later. Let's see what we got here. God, Yoshi's Island is so good. That's what that song was from. BT dubs. How's everybody doing tonight? I don't think I ended up asking that yet. Hope you're all doing well. Anybody working on some cool shit? Or have some fun plans? Got lots of cool friends that are always cooking up some interesting shit. Under desk treadmill? That's interesting. So do you walk while you're working? Because I've tried standing desk, but that sounds cray-cray. Cray-cray, as the youth would say. Cybertruck? What's a Cybertruck? Is that like the ones that they put Xboxes in to try to encourage kids to join the army or whatever? God, this is a weird shape. Newelcat says, yep, only got it because my company reimburses fitness-related expenses. God dang. I'd imagine that was still expensive, but... The Muskmobile, the 20 poly stainless steel one. Let me... Oh, Slime Slime, hello!
Hi.
How's it going? It's good to see you. I know we have, like, a big time difference, or time zone difference, so it's really cool to when you're able to drop in. I'm gonna shout you out. Let's see if I can spell. Your name is challenging to spell, so let me I always get like psychic and physics and those kind of words mixed up. Did I do it right? I think I did it right. Yeah, I did. Okay, so Slime Slime is a not only a fellow VTuber, but a fellow slime enthusiast. That makes it sound like it's something T14, but I assure you. Just a really cool, like, game engine based slime VTuber with a bunch of, like, interactive things you can do, and oh, cool, the avatar's in the way. Hold on. Let me... Oh my god, Fruitsy, get it the fuck together. Okay. But yeah, you saw it. There's a little slime on a tank. And you can have, like, your own little slime in the environment. You can equip them with stuff. So yeah. Go ahead and check Slime Slime out. I gotta get some kind of, like, cool automated, like, clip player thing like Dead Sun has in his stream. How's it going, Slime Slime? Let's see, I gotta get the front view of this thing. Or I guess the... Yeah, I don't know. Would that be considered the front view? Alright. And then we'll rotate that by 90 degrees. 90... am I making a ship or a controller? Yeah, the second one. Yeah, we're making a Dreamcast controller, among other ones, because we have a little game console over there you can see in the back. It's the Slimecast. It's got a couple of controller ports that I'm gonna make a bunch of dumb gimmick controllers for. Oh! We got a raid! Hang on a second. Let's see if my raid actually works. There we go. Welcome raiders to the stream. We're so glad that you are all raiding here. We really appreciate you raiding because we love to get more eyes on the stream. I gotta keep workshopping that song. Hello raiders, how's it going? Let's see, oh my goodness, there's so much going on in chat. Church HB, hello. Let me see if I can, we just shouted somebody out, so let me see if I can shout somebody out if there needs to be a cooldown. Yeah, no, yeah. Church HB. Looks like Church HB is another fellow VTuber. Oh my god, an ad. But yeah, you can see very cute. Oh my god. Very cute anime VTuber. I really like the outfit. This is a very cute outfit. Playing some fighting games. Yeah, thank you so much for trusting us with your crew. Yeah, if you need to take care of yourself, get yourself some water, or do some stretches, or if you need to duck out to take a break. Deadson says church is great. Yeah, from the couple of seconds I saw. Actually, I think you've raided church before, Deadson. I vaguely remember that. Yeah. Let's see. Let me make sure I am caught up with chat. And let me turn my music back on so there isn't dead silence. Church raid. Yeah, so for anybody that's new to the channel, hi, I'm Fruitsy Collins, I'm a VTuber, I'm an artist, 3D modeler, illustrator, Unreal Engine developer. We have a whole interactive game engine environment here. There's all kinds of crazy interactive shit that we can do. The most kind of signature thing that we have... Oh, thank you, Anima! The most kind of like, you know, back of the box feature that we've got is this little virtual pet system. So the first time that you type in chat, you should get a little guy that will be your forever slime. They're your little virtual pet. And there's all kinds of things you can do to equip them with things. You can give them head pats. I'm going to pet my boy Goop here. There's my little ghost slime Goop. And you can like feed him fruit to evolve them into things. And we have a little racing mini game. There's all kinds of fun stuff. Yeah, the about section goes into a ton of detail about that. Dead Son's little one whose name keeps changing. Did a little spell. Looks like the rug from Animal Crossing. That's because it is. Very good observation. I really like that carpet, and I want to have that in real life. A lot of the things in this environment are things that I would like to have in real life, but cannot because money, or because they don't exist in real life. So instead I 3D model them and put them in my fake office. So, I mentioned slime races earlier. If you would like your little ones to be able to do stuff like Dead Sun's little one did, we have a little mini game where you can win that stuff. So we're going to head over and do that right now. Oh, Mixie, hello! Mixie, I did revise the geysers a little bit. They're a little nerfed, so hopefully we don't get stun locked as much. Okay, so if you would like to have your little one compete in this race, go ahead and type exclamation point play. And even if you don't have one yet, it'll make one for you. And that'll be your forever boy. We have 8 little places on the field. So it's going to fill up fast, it looks like. And yeah, this is a little mini game for your little one to learn how to like cast magic spells and play instruments and stuff. And yeah, whoever wins first, second, and third place will win little abilities to unlock. We got one more spot on the field. You feel an attachment to your little guy? That is the goal. Yeah. Every time I add a feature, it's like I try to keep in mind what's going to make people emotionally invested in this little fake thing. Redacted. Playing a nice little Chrono Trigger song on a tiny trumpet. Oh, Mercedes Vib. There we go. Okay, we got 8 boys on the field. If you didn't get a chance to be in this race, don't worry. We're gonna hold a couple more throughout the evening. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so for anybody new, the way this minigame works is that your little one has a random chance of falling asleep every once in a while. And if they fall asleep, you can type cheer into chat to wake them up a little bit faster. And anything with cheer in it will work. So if you get like repeat messages, like errors, you can type anything with the word cheer in it. All right, Mixie is... Oh, I was going to say Mixie is in first place, but has fallen to second, but everybody's still pretty close together. I'm going to go full screen so I can read everybody's usernames. All right. Redacted pulling ahead as we move on to the second stage of Slime Race Island, the perilous waterfall bridge, the very low poly log suspension bridge. Slime Race Island has been kind of Halloween themed for a spooky month. Normally it looks a lot more green and lush, but we made it spooky tonight. Alright, Mixie pulling ahead again. Pretty decisive lead. Top 3 slimes will win prizes, but first place slime will win an extra special one. Alright, we are getting to Geyser Valley, the final stretch. These little geothermal vents can push your little one back a few centimeters. And hopefully, I nerf them a little bit, so hopefully nobody gets stuck completely. Mixie had a little bit of trouble with RNGesus the last stream. Alright, Mixie approaching their geyser. Oh, yep, just narrowly avoiding it. Looks like it's between Mixie and Mercedes Veb. Or Mixie and Halo, excuse me. Who will RNGesus bless? Alright. Do you believe in comebacks? That is not what the idiom is, but whatever. Mixie has won their first slime race. Wrench from the jaws of defeat. Followed by Halo. Oh, I don't know if Church or Carl won that. I think it might have been Church, but we'll see once we go to the race results island, once everybody else finishes up. We'll see who won that third place prize. Very solid performance out of all of you. As Approxim's little one and Redacted finish up. All right, congratulations to everybody. Let me try to catch up with chat, because I have had this full screen the whole time. Let me make sure I'm not missing anything super important. All right, cheer. Cool. All right, let's go to Race Results Island and see what, who won and what they won. Who got third place? Oh, looks like it's Dead Sun's little one, Carl. Congratulations. And congratulations to Mixie. You're going to get a gold feather in your cap for winning a race. And then Carl will win Little Song as a runner-up prize. Halo won a little drum song, and Mixie will get an extra special prize. Oh, they learned how to draw a little star. Very nice. Yeah, you'll be able to draw that on my carpet. Very nice. Thank you all. Boy, it is getting crowded over there. Oh, there you go. Oh, our other little friend, Whisper the Ghost, is getting in the way. There we go. Oh, it is very crowded over there. Let's see, I'm going to have my little boy cast some magic. Or I'll have him do a drawing of his own. Let's see. Oh, you know, yeah, he knows how to draw a star, too. Church petting their little one while they're hidden. Thank you all for participating in that. That was very fun. We are going to get back to work here. Oh, green hair. Very nice. Yeah, you can change my hair color with redeems. There's all kinds of other fun stuff that you can do with channel points. Yeah, I like the green hair. It's nice. Yeah, we're doing a little bit of 3D modeling tonight. We are modeling a couple of video game controllers for another mini game that I have planned for the future. Church says this is so cool, Fritzy. You've done a ton of work. Thank you. I have done a ton of work, and I really do appreciate the compliments. I've also recently got hand tracking working. Well, almost working. There we go. Cool. The lefty is always a little hard to track because I use my iPhone in front of my face to do the facial capture, and sometimes they don't like playing nicely together. So yeah, we're modeling a Dreamcast controller to start with. I have this little schematic to help me out, because Dreamcast is a very weirdly shaped controller. Bye-bye. Thank you for watering Mandy. Mandy is our little office mandragora. Oh, Church says, Oh, thank you for following Material Vex. Yeah, welcome to the coven. I'm glad you're here. Church says I'm going to have to head out because my brother is heading into town, but I hope you have a lovely rest of your stream and day. I will have a very lovely stream, especially since you brought your community into here and we had some fun playing video games or mini games. And I hope you enjoy your brother being in town. Say hi to them for me. Actually, maybe not, because it would be weird to say, like, some VTuber, just that they don't know said hi. But anyway, I hope you have a good night. Thank you. Thank you again for the raid, Church. Oh, Pokey, that's a cute name. Oh, yeah, Material Vex. If you check out the channel points... Oh, I got Sakura hair. Hi. Yeah, you should have a little slime guy since you've chatted for the first time. And, actually, maybe... It might have to be a regular message, I'm not sure. But yeah, you should have a little slime, I think. Yeah, because the redeems also do it. So yeah, you can check the channel points menu and also the about section. But yeah, I'm sure you'll figure it out. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask me anything you want. Yeah, very glad to have you here, Material Vex. Let me know if I'm saying your name correctly. You love them, I'm glad. Uh-huh. Let's see, we're gonna have to move this back a little bit because it's getting in our way. There we go. How's your evening going, Material? Really appreciate the follow. Doing good, just chilling. Love to hear it. This is quite a challenging shape. This here controller. Yeah, I mean, it is a weird shape for a controller, but it's also sort of the, I think it's sort of the template for how a lot of modern video game controllers look nowadays. Because, like, the Xbox kind of ripped off the Dreamcast design. Oh, wow, that's a really nice color. It's a very satisfying magenta. I like it. Good choice. But yeah, the Xbox controller sort of ripped off the Dreamcast controller's design. And then everybody ripped off that. Pink is your favorite? Yeah, purple's my favorite, but pink is a close second. Yeah, my palette's sort of purple and pink. Hey, Django. I don't know if you heard that, but my kitty cat is talking. Very nice choice of hat. Yeah, that little TV behind your little one is Kitty, yes indeed. I have a little black cat. His name's Django. He's my little void cat. Oh my god, he's got the zoomies. Hi, buddy. Oh, Mixie's eating a feisty fruit. Oh, that's not a good way to... Let's see here. I think if we extrude this... did you make that yourself, or is it a thing you can buy? Do you mean the TV I was talking about? That one was modeled by me, if that's what you're talking about. But yeah, pretty much everything in this room was modeled by me, except for the Majora's Mask references up there, and some of the little like video game referencey things in the room. But most of it was modeled by me, except for we have a couple of models over here. These are some friends of the show. Two of them are here right now. Deadson Prime and Noodlecat Does Things. Those are little models that they provided me, so that I can do little shout outs of them. These are little simplified versions of their avatars. Oops, I pressed the wrong button for that. Hang on a second. There we go. Oh, that was weird. So your model and code for the most part, yeah. The hand tracking is a lot of it's my code, but then the kind of the nuts and bolts of it was by somebody named Mega Mocap VR, who's another streamer who's an Unreal Engine developer that really helped me get a lot of this. Let me see, left hand. Oop. Oh my god, lefty is always a challenge. Anyway, I'll do most of my acting with the right hand, but yeah, Mega Mocap VR really helped me with this. But yeah, for the most part, a lot of the stuff in here was coded by me, you know, after a fashion of me piecing together YouTube tutorials and stuff. So, you know, nothing's really original. Oh, Mydragora, hello! Yeah, Noodlecat is being very sturdy there. Oh, I'm so good. Thank you very much, Material Bugs. I appreciate that. I'm gonna resist the urge to fight against a compliment. And I will try to just accept it gracefully. Thank you for watering, Mandy. Oh, very high-pitched voice. Thank you, Noodlecat. I appreciate it. Yeah, if any of y'all want to check out other people doing similar things to me, if you look down below the About section, I believe, or below my front page, there should be a user group called Unreal Engine VTubers. And a lot of them are using, like, game engines to do a lot of, like, interactive stuff with, like, custom avatars that I'm doing. So, yeah, you'll meet a lot of really cool people if you browse through that. Very cool community that we have here. And I think a lot of the people in the like the game development VTuber community also tend to I've been low polyed. They tend to skew a little bit older, so I think you end up getting like a very nice, like mellow, like kind group of people that are very knowledgeable about what they do. Oh no, I've been low polyed, you guys. Oh, where'd all my lumens and my nanites go, and my virtual textures and my level streaming and my blueprints and my enumerators and my data tables, so where'd they all go? Ah, heck. This looks nice with pink hair, actually. Low poly, yes. That's the low poly avatar. I want to make some improvements to the... Oh, Evan T-pose, too. Nerd. Noodlecat, I'm not a nerd. I'm a Unreal Engine developer VTuber. I'm the furthest thing from a nerd you could possibly get. Good God, I'm a nerd. How's the music volume for everybody? I'm doing kind of a different audio routing than I'm used to. How'd you make that low poly model? I've been wanting to make an animation in the South for a long time. Let's see. I don't know how. Is it Blender? Please don't be... it is Blender, but you could really use any 3D modeling program to do something like this. They're all kind of just different tools for doing the same thing. So the way that I... Hey everybody, it's me! Pumpkin Potion! Ha-cha-cha-cha-cha! Anyway. But yeah, if the way that I did this model in particular was, there is a website called The Modeler's Resource. I'm gonna bring it up. Yeah, so... there is a website called Modeler's Resource. Oh my god, green screen doesn't work when we're in black and white mode. But anyway, it's called the Modeler's Resource. There are a ton of like models that have been ripped from video games and stuff. And so what I did was I looked at a lot of these for references and sort of pieced together different traits and outfits to make this avatar. Because I have a lot of nostalgia for like Bravely Default and the Final Fantasy, like, 3D remakes. But yeah, Modeler's Resource is a really good like resource for like seeing how people made 3D models for video games and how they animated them and stuff. So yeah, if there's ever a style that you're going for, definitely check this out as a resource. Very helpful. I gotta make it so that when I'm in, I gotta make the volume for this black and white effect not encompass the green screen section. I'm gonna write that down. Let's see. Yeah, because I do my transparency with green screen. Black and white mode, green screen outside of... volume. Hopefully I'll remember what that means. Yeah, that's, I know you were playing one of those. I think you were playing 3, correct? Oh, we have a wasp in the house. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Wow, that is blown out. Am I stuck in black and white? Well, it has a 5-minute timer, so after 5 minutes, color, we'll get out of Kansas and go back to Oz. Am I pumpkin potions? No. That would be high praise, because, like, the pumpkin potions was definitely one of the inspirations for, like, having this environment kind of work the way that it does. Especially... like friends of the show, attorneys general, Woody Devs and Vel Pepper both worked on Pumpkin Potions environment with the 3D modeling and the Unreal engine, like interactivity. Is this PlayStation 1 look? I'm back. Oh, good. I can hardly breathe in there. Yeah, the low poly aperture was more of a Nintendo 3D. I think it was just the regular DS. Yeah, it was just modeled after the Final Fantasy remakes. It's kind of comparable in terms of like poly count, though. Let's see. See, this is a weird shape. Such a strange shape. Something like that. Yeah, something along these lines. Let's see, I went on to Sketchfab. Oh, if you ever also are like new to 3D modeling and you want a good resource for kind of learning how to do it, if you go on this website called Sketchfab, they have a model viewer where you can check out a model in different modes, like wireframe and like, you know, base color. And looking at stuff in wireframe mode that other people have done is very helpful to like kind of figure out, you know, how people approach... you know, just modeling in general. And sometimes they also have models that are free to download, like with attribution and stuff. So if you ever want to like not have to reinvent the wheel in terms of using a 3D model, sometimes that could be a good resource. You always have to just double check that you're following their licensing guidelines. But yeah, well, that's one of the things that I try to do when I, you know, challenge with how to represent something's geometry. This is a very strange shape. I'm going to take a little bit of a break, because with all the activity in here and introducing myself, I have run out of breath pretty badly, so I am going to take a little bit of a break, and you can all enjoy your little ones. BRB. Royal Rumble. Yeah, Dead Sun wants me to do like a battle royale. Let's see. There we go. Sometimes they get stuck, so hopefully they're not stuck anymore. BRB. I have returned. Play me back in, Goop. Hi, everybody. I'm gonna turn my desk light on so my camera tracking. There we go, works a little better. There we go. Okay, I am having some trouble with this weird ass shape. Let's see what we got here. I'm gonna hide this part. Thank you for watering Mandy. She's got a little flower on her head. Yeah, Mandy can grow a little fruit that gets assigned randomly at the beginning of the stream. So even I don't know what she's gonna grow. Oh, that wasp is in your lamp. I think you're gonna have to burn the place down and just cut your losses. Oh, wasp or no joke. Godspeed. Let's see here. Actually, I think I have a Dreamcast controller. I should just get that and look at it in IRL as a reference. Hold on, I'll be a BRB.
Hi. fine.
Just realized I didn't turn my mic off. I could not find my Dreamcast controller. I found my Dreamcast, but I couldn't find the dang controller. Let's see here. Okay, so I guess we're going to rely on Sketchfab. Oh, we got a little ad break. Oh, somebody laid an egg. We have a breeding system here. There we go, make some space. Get this out of the way. Don't need quite this much space. There we go. Okay. Hi, German Tanker. How's it going? I never know whether to call you German Tanker or whether to call you Johnny, so let me know which one you prefer. How's it going tonight? We're doing a little 3D modeling here. Not a whole lot of 3D modeling because I'm slow as hell, but I probably should have started with a simpler one. Okay, I'll go with Johnny, or I'll go with German Tanker. Hope your evening's going all right. Okay, so there's a little fatter on the bottom. Little in the middle, but it's got much back. Kids drawing on my floors. I bought you a giant fucking ream of butcher paper to draw all over my carpet. Ooh, I like this song. That song's from Moon Remix RPG. But I think the one before that was as well. Yeah, the game's got good music. Is this in my last TikTok video? Oh, we had a baby.
New soul arrives.
Nope. That is. Why did I go back to this cam? There we go. Okay, so Aproxim and Monochrome had a baby named Aprom TV. Where's our little one? Oh, is that a little yellow one there? Yeah. A little yellow one with the eggy hat. Hi, little guy. I adjusted the birth rate yet again. Yeah, it's kind of getting there. I think this is the correct, like, general shape. Oh yeah, Mixie, somebody had a baby. That little yellow one there.
Hi.
Aprom TV. Let me shove the boys around a second. Oh, there he goes.
Hi.
Yeah, the little yellow one there. There you go. Cute little yolk yellow. Why did I start with a Dreamcast controller? Okay, I think that's kind of the general shape. Okay, so here's the center part. Hi, Django. Let's put a mirror modifier on this. Make that in the Y direction. Hi, Django. Oh my god, he's such a noisy boy. Yeah, hi, buddy. I gave him some kitty weed. I was hoping that would quiet him down.
Bye.
So you mirror that, and we want that in the Y direction. There we go. Mesh. Let's see. We want a cylinder. How many verts do we want? Let's try 16. 16. What about 8's probably not. Yeah, no, 8's way too few. 12. Yeah, let's do 16. Why not? Let's go crazy. Poly count be damned. Actually, we probably should have. Yeah, never mind. These controller handles sort of. They sort of slope up to meet the center part. I couldn't find my Dreamcast control. I was digging through my cabinet of old video game stuff, and I found the Dreamcast itself, but not the controller. I might go and do the bongos just as like a confidence booster. Yeah, this is not looking too far off at the moment. Fire spell, look out now. Oh, another baby. Oh, almost there. Thank you for watering, Mandy. A couple more waters ought to do it. Find out what Mandy's cooking up in there. Ooh. Nice ice spell, Halo. Oh, Mixie, I think, I forgot to mention, I taught your little one a level 2 spell. I forget which element it was, but should have access to that. I'm also going to double check that you also have, make sure you have the level 1 spell as well, otherwise that could cause some issues. There we go. Yeah, I gave you a second level spell just as an apology for getting stunlocked last time. Huh? That's not looking too far off, I think. Okay, and then there's a cube. Hello, the Bigly. How's it going? Always good to see you. How are you doing tonight? We're doing a little 3D modeling here. Okay, then we'll add a cube. The king of emotes. How are you doing tonight, the Big Lee?
Hi.
We're just modeling a controller over here. Gets drawn on my floors again. Would you all draw? Who's paying for this carpet? It looks like somebody drew a little fishy. I think I saw a little Kirby fish there. We don't have an underside view. Okay, so this cylinder should be the first kind of tier of this thickness. So that kind of comes down to here. And it kind of tapers in.
A new soul arrives.
New soul arrives. Space Buffoon and Proxim. Proxim's little one's getting around. A proof foom. Let's see if we can find them. Yeah, there we go. A little red one there. Aw, a little cutie. Oh, another Iggy. Okay, we're having kid slimes around the rate that I would like. So I think this might be a good birth rate. Because it is happening every once in a while, but it's not like every 2 minutes. That's good. Mega Manual. Okay, gotta head out. Yeah. Thank you so much for the follow. We really appreciate it. Yeah, I hope I see you again. Have a good night. And thank you for the compliment as well. Something like that, I guess. A little Dubois music.
Ahoy.
This comes out here, and these boys. Thank you for the Final Fantasy VI music. There we go. Something like that.
A new soul arrives.
Nilcat does things and sees Hornsby. That old one. I think it might be that blue one there. Yeah, Noodlecat Dornsby. Redacted celebrating the birth of their child there. Heralding with trumpets. I guess trumpets would be more for the apocalypse, I'm not sure. Sort of like that, I guess. Bye-bye. Okay, so that's a pretty basic Dreamcast controller shape. Let me modify this a little bit. Wow. I think this curves up a little bit. Noodle does have a kid. Okay, so that's sort of what a Dreamcast controller looks like. This isn't going to be the actual model. I'm just sort of blocking out the weird ass shape that it is. Actually, this should taper in a little more. Hi Django, hi buddy. Meow. Oh, thank you for the hydrate. I do need that. I just spilled water all over myself. I will take that opportunity to also do a stretch break. Thank you very much, Mixie. We'll go to the slime cam while I do all that human stuff. Yeah, Space Buffoon, I think he did have a baby with Approxim, was that their name? I think they might be an absentee parent or perhaps just a lurking parent. Sorry for the noise. I went to an Asian bakery today and I have some yummy breads. They come in very crinkly plastic. I'm gonna turn my mic off and take a bite of that. Yeah. Okay, done chewing on that. I think it's melon bread. Something like that. It's a big round piece of bread with a kind of like cross pattern on the top. It's yummy, whatever it is. Okay, so I am good on Dreamcast. Excuse me. I'm good on Dreamcast for the moment. I think we're going to tackle something a little easier for our next one, and then we'll revisit the Dreamcast. Oh my god, come on. Oh, thank you for the head pats, Space Buffoon. I'm going to shout out Space Buffoon. Shoutouts are not contingent on head pats, but I like Space Buffoon quite a bit. And Space Buffoon does very cute lore streams, as a very fun avatar with good world building. And since last time I shouted Space Buffoon out, we were in black and white mode, I would like to show a little bit.
The Gribbly Grooves, at first...
But yeah, that's Space Buffoon's little one.
Kind of a Gribbly Star Wars Groo merchant type, where it was like, ah, bah, 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 that kind of merchant. Uh-oh. Gribbly Groo, hold on! Those darn space helicopters.
Yeah, Space Buffoon's got this whole world-building thing, where they're a kind of clown-based fighter pilot in this big, like, epic space opera with all kinds of cool little creatures and character arcs and stuff. And I really admire their work. And they're also a very sweet, fun person to hang out with. So we are going to jump off of Dreamcast for a minute and do something a little easier. If we can figure out where that folder went. Okay. Oh, we're getting some frame dropping. The heck? Let's see. We will call this Bongo. Because we're going to do the Donkey Kong Bongo controller. Which should be a lot easier. Oh my god, my computer is hitching for some reason. Yeah, we're gonna do a couple of these boys. Ooh. I think there's an earthquake here, IRL. Yeah, things are shaking. Study the blade. Ground is shaking quite a bit. I may or may not have to get up and stand in a door frame if it picks up. I've been getting a couple. Yeah, I'm gonna go stand in a door frame. It's not shaking that much, but I'll. Just to be safe. BRB.
Bye.
Okay, yeah, it seemed to die down. It's kind of a, it was not very intense, but it was very long. Raising beer, T for teen. I'm not too afraid of earthquakes because I used to live in California where, like, they were just sort of happening all the time to the point where I didn't even notice them. But I recently moved to a part of the world where that is not very common. So everybody freaks out. It's still kind of going on. At least I think it is. It's very mild, though. I've been through a lot worse. I wonder if that's why Django's meowing so much. Hi, well, thank you, Mixie. Yeah, I know how to handle earthquakes. I would be more worried about, I live near a mountain that is still technically an active volcano. It has not erupted in, like, hundreds of years, but, if it did, that would be very bad. I don't think that there's any danger of that happening anytime soon. It is not an extremely active volcano. Okay, let's do bongos. How many? Yeah, I think 12 should be enough. So how much do we rotate this? 16? Oh, that doesn't look right. 15.5? No, 15? Oh, geometry. Yeah, I think 15 degrees is right. We want the sides to be on the top and side. Let's see. So if that's the size of a Dreamcast controller. Wait a minute, what happened to the rest of it? What happened to the rest of the Dreamcast controller? Cylinder, empty, empty. William, hello! First time chat. Welcome to the stream. Nice to meet you. How's it going, William? Since you chatted for the first time, it's a little crowded over there, but you should have a little slime that was made for you. If you want to see them, you can give them a pat on the head. And it'll hide all the other ones. That's my boy Goop. Yeah, we got like a whole virtual pet system here. And there's all kinds of stuff you can do with them, with channel points and stuff. I kind of did the whole, like, spiel about them a couple of times tonight, so if you have any specific questions about them, let me know. Mine successfully blown. Yeah, this is all running in Unreal Engine, so that lets us do a bunch of really fun interactive things. How are you doing tonight, William? Technical, what are you doing and why? I am VTubing. Yeah, so this whole thing is basically running in Unreal Engine. It's kind of a game. And then it is also communicating with the Twitch server to monitor what's happening in chat and what's happening with the channel redeems. And then I just like programmed a bunch of stuff that happens in response to things that happen in chat. So yeah, that's the long and short of it. Oh, gray hair. Nice. I'm like every dark-skinned character in anime that just has silver hair. I don't know why that's such a common thing. We're doing a little 3D modeling here. We're going to have a little video game system in the corner there by the slimes, and so I'm modeling a bunch of gimmicky video game controllers. Oh, funny I went with that avatar. Yeah, it's just, yeah, this is a character that I used to be primarily an illustrator. I mostly 3D model now, so this is a character that's sort of like my favorite character to draw. So like I made a 3D model of her, and then when I started getting interested in VTubing, I decided to just use her as an avatar since she was like the most developed thing I had, and I have a lot of affection for the character. Is that the target audience, Two Mean Chicks? It's not really like a target audience. I guess it would be like, it'd probably be just people in their like 20s to 30s that have nostalgia for like magical girl shows and maybe like Steven Universe and like old video game things, you know, like Dreamcast, PS2 era. I don't know. I'm mostly just making stuff that I like personally, and hoping that appeals to other people. So, not so much a target demographic. So yeah, I think probably my audience skews more female and like LGBTQ. Yeah, I'm non-binary myself. But yeah, I think we have all types in here. Let's see, we're trying to model the Donkey Kong bongos. Yeah, there's downloading the components. There is a program called there's Vroid, which is kind of a program for making more like traditional like anime based stuff. And that will make a model for you, and you have a lot of customization options. And then those plug into a program called VNeon, which is like a whole like streaming environment that has like interactive stuff built in and like hand tracking and face tracking and all that. So that program kind of exists. But if you want to make something that looks like not like traditional anime or like something, if you really want to make something super custom, you'll probably need to make something in Blender and use a game engine like Unity or Unreal or what have you. Yeah, there's a lot of people that do really cool stuff within VNeon. So VNeon is kind of, it has less barrier to entry because a lot of the stuff is like built for you, so you don't have to spend a lot of time like reinventing the wheel like I've had to with this thing. So, but a lot of this is an exercise in learning how to do game development stuff too, so I don't mind rebuilding things from scratch. Hey Whisper, how's it going? There's a little ghost boy Whisper. Can't reach our boy. Yeah, we're haunted by that little fella. Oh, Kisa Satoma. Yeah, Kisa Satoma is another VTuber, very much a friend of the show. Kisa Satoma, I think you do you use VNeon or VC Face or Water. I don't know a whole lot about like that like side of VTubing, really. I don't have first-hand experience with it. There's someone named Kana Fuyuko. I'll just show you what they look like. Let's see. Yeah, there's a VTuber named Kana Fuyuko, and she has like a ton of like tutorials and kind of overviews of using things like Vroid, VC Face, Vignon, Waterdo, Blender stuff. She's a good person to check out if you want to get like overview of like what's possible with that kind of stuff. Yeah, it's that kind of stuff is very versatile. Like, I have a friend named Vel Pepper who is, I believe, uses VC Face or Vignon, and their character is not anime at all. They're like this little weird, like chubby chicken character. So you can definitely go off the beaten path. It's definitely like it is definitely a tool that is easy to use if you want to make a more traditional anime looking character. So if that is a goal, then that's definitely a good place to start. Vel Pepper is a very good bean. I agree 1,000% with Kisa Satoma. Let's see, where is our pure ref? Oh, so William, do you do like 3D modeling and work and stuff? Sorry, I was thinking more than I was reading. Let's see. So this is split up into three different sections. So we will need two cuts. And I think the middle section is a little taller. And then we can hide the Dreamcast thing. Where is my... I need my floor and my axes. Where's my grid? I need my grid. Oh, I do have a grid. It's just this object's very small. Oh, wait. I didn't need to extrude that. We need to mirror this boy. Hi, Django. Oh my god, my cat's being such a talker. Yeah, hi, buddy. Hi, buddy. Yeah, Django's my cat, for anybody who's wondering why I keep who I'm yelling at. Void Ball of Doom. Yeah, he's a void cat. Very appropriate for Halloween. I have a little Dracula cape for him, but I can't get him to wear that thing. He turns into the Tasmanian devil when I try to put clothes on him. He's very feisty. Oh, there he goes. Guy's got the zoomies. He's quite a rowdy boy. Yeah, so that's basically the bongos. Like, it's kind of done already. I think I'm going to hold a little slime race to pick the energy up a little bit. Anybody be interested in that? Let's go ahead and go to Slime Race Island. This is the mini game that we do for slimes to learn how to do little special actions, like playing songs and drawing on the floor and casting spells. We love casting spells. So yeah, if anybody would like to join, go ahead and type exclamation point play. And your little one will be whisked away to Slime Race Island. And first, second, and third place will win prizes. We got Kisa Satoma's little one Critter on the field. I'm gonna go ahead and have Goop join. Come on in. There you go, Goop. Goop's my special boy. I usually have him sit out because I want other people to win prizes, but sometimes I take him off the bench if we don't have a full house. Might just be a 1v1 between Goop and Critter, but we'll see. I'll count down from 10 in case... Oh, there we go. Mixie's in there. Cool. Mixie won their first race earlier. Won a little... I think they learned how to draw a star on the floor for getting first place. And they have a little gold feather in their cap for also for getting first place. I'm gonna do a 10 count, give people a chance to join if they would like to, but not hold things up too much. Oh, you didn't get water? You mean for your spell? Yeah, I forget which element that I gave you. Let's see. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Oh, you didn't. Oh, right. Yeah. The last race, you completely cleared it, I think. Yeah. You dodged it entirely. Okay. I think we'll go ahead and get started. All right. We are off to the races. We've got Critter, Goop, and Mixie, three season champions. We are approaching the summit of Bunny Hill. Goop is taking a little bit of an early lead. Critter is being a little bit of a sleepy boy. But things are still very close. It is still anybody's race very early on as we get to the bottom of Bunny Hill. Oh, Goop pulling ahead. Goop being a real tryhard. Oh, he's just showing off for company. Oh, there he goes. He fell asleep. Cheer, Goop. Oh, you missed it. Hello, Osiris. I don't know if I'm saying your name right, and I don't know if you've corrected me already, so let me know. I'm notoriously bad with pronouncing people's usernames. All right, Goop has pulled back ahead. Yeah, we can have another race later. Osiris. Okay, cool. I'll keep that in mind. All right, Mixie's pulling ahead. Critter being a very sleepy bean. All right, we are making our way the final stretch of Slime Race Island, Geyser Valley. Recently nerfed Geyser Valley. Oh, let's see. Did Mixie get hit with the water? No, very narrowly avoided getting hit with the water. Solid performance from Mixie tonight. Mixie had something to prove tonight after getting double stun locked the first two races in the last stream we had. Might be a little early to call, but I think Mixie might win a second race. Congratulations to them. Now it's between Critter and Goop. I haven't been cheering my boy on very much, but now it's time for me to get serious. But I think Critter might be our number two. There we go. Congratulations to Kisa's Toman, their little one Critter. Goop dragging his ass across the finish line. Always a disappointment. No. Goop's my special boy. We like to kid around here. Alright, since there are three beans in the race, they will all win prizes. Mixie will win an extra special one, so let's go to the results island. Check out what they all got. 2-7, that's pretty close to the record time. Hawkeye, I think, holds her world record 157. Mixie won't win another gold feather, but they will get an extra special prize. But first, Goop will win a Yoshi's Island song and a Fisher Price piano. Critter won a little Zelda song. And Mixie will win. Oh, they wanted to draw a little sunfish. A little Kirby fish. Very nice. I think Critter also knows how to draw that. They all went to the same art school. They all went to CalArts. Fish indeed. Let me pet my little guy. This is fishy. Oh, I did slime special action, not pet. Oh well. Goop knows how I feel. How are you doing, Osiris? It's pretty crowded over there. There we go. I have a button to reset their movement, like AI. In case I get stuck. There are a lot of baby slimes. Yeah, I did adjust the birth rate, and I think we're getting kid slimes about the rate that is appropriate for how many people there are. Oh, you just woke up? Well, good morning then. I don't know what time it is in your part of the world. Yeah, I might need to upgrade the baby jail. Yeah, there's... I don't know. Yeah, if the channel grows more than it has, I might have to start... my battery is running out. Hang on a second. There we go, my facial capture device, also known as my phone. It's running a little low.
Friendship.
Slime race in this economy? Hello, Griffin! Yeah, shout out Griffin Moore. Griffin Moore is another VTuber that is a big friend of the show, if I may be so bold. How's it going, Griffin? Very good to see you. Oop, hand tracking. There we go. Hi! I'm gonna show off a little bit of what Griffin Moore does. Griffinmore also uses Unreal Engine to do streaming. Let's see here.
New segment. Called Confess. Let's go.
Griffin has a little bounce house that he puts people in as punishment.
Look at this right here.
He's got this whole 3D environment that he can do a bunch of interactive stuff.
These are all anonymous, folks. Anonymous confessions. Cheese makes it hard to poop.
Confess your sins.
That's right. Get it off your chest, folks. It does make it hard to poop, especially if you're
Oh, ad break.
Anonymous confession number two. Mood killer. I wish I could be more active in this community. The truth is, my finances have been...
Yeah, Griffin, in addition to being a very cool developer in Unreal Engine, is also a very swell guy that is a blast to hang out with. Definitely someone I look up to. How are you doing, Giant Griffin? We're doing a little 3D modeling.
Smash that subscribe.
Oh! I think you've been resubscribing, Griffin Moore. Thank you so much. We love seeing Pavlok. Really, really appreciate it. We're making some bongos, the little DK bongo beats, jungle beats, whatever the hell it was called. We're making like a whole line of like gimmicky controllers for the little slime TV over in the corner there. They're gonna sit in front of it. Yeah, we've got the bongos. We're gonna do the weird-ass 3D controller that the Sega Saturn had. We're gonna do this fucking monstrosity, the GameCube, like, Phantasy Star Online keyboard thing. We're doing a Dreamcast controller. I think that'll be it. That should be four, I think. Yeah, I never had a Saturn. It is quite a design for a controller. I don't know how comfortable that is to hold. It is the opposite of little in the middle, and it doesn't look like it has much back. Let's see, vertex groups. How do I merge these? Why have I forgotten how to model? Merge by distance. Wait a minute. It looks like there's an extra face here. Yeah, there is. Why doesn't it? Oh, I know why. I know why it's not merging. I'm not selecting all of them. There we go. It was weird but usable. Yeah, that was sort of like, I guess the Saturn was never really intended to be a 3D system from what I hear. Like its internal architecture was like, you could do 3D graphics, but it was definitely not like built from the ground up to do it. Phantasy Star Online was fun. Yeah, I missed that one. I never got to play it. My Puref. Okay, this should be thicker. Bring that down a little bit.
Bye-bye.
Gonna rig the Candyman? Is that a... is that a euphemism for some kind of T for teen thing? You know how I feel about that, Griffin. Dead Sun's like, yeah. I'm just Drake and Josh in ya. You know me. Yeah, I love T for Teen. I love all the fantasy violence. I love all the suggested use of alcohol. Why isn't my hand doing it? Yeah. Suggested use of alcohol. Mild suggestive themes. Yeah, there you go. There's the T for Teen. Yeah, what we got? Scary moments. Oh man, love those. Love scary moments. I whisper. Can we? Reach out and touch fate. Oh god. Okay, fuck it. Just love that South Park humor. Let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and skip this song and there we go. Let's see here. Yay thick. Just kind of move that in. I think we can split this in half. And I'll mirror it. Oh, too feisty fruit. Going down that kitty slime route. Yeah, if you would like to see the slime forms that they can evolve into, we have a website in the About section, the Slime Archive, and that has a evolution chart that has all the forms that people have gotten so far. Still a couple people I haven't found yet. There we go. There's our bongos. We are going to have to... I guess we'll do a triangle fan. Actually, Yeah, that's fine. In the center. There we go. Are there any details we are sorely missing? And that's just got a big button there. And the rest of that can just be normal map stuff. It's smooth. Whoa. I think we might have something fucky going on there. Let's see if we have any extra faces. What the hell? Oh, I know what it is. We didn't set this to clip. There we go. It's smooth. Here we go. Yeah, I think that's what the problem is. That looks like a nightmare, but I think with the normal map and my coloring, this should look fine. And unless there's some weird... Oh, how do I display my face orientation? No, okay, that's all. Those faces are all correct. Yeah, let's just set it all to smooth. I should probably, maybe all the controllers should have, yeah, I think all the controllers should share a texture sheet. So they're gonna be fairly small, so they can maybe just share one, like 1024 texture sheet, maybe. I've been streaming for about 2.5 hours, so I think maybe we'll call it a night. And then maybe have one more slime race, and then find somebody cool to raid. How's it sound to everybody? Let me turn the music down. Because we have the Sonic, our soundtrack for this mini game. H's. Trying to run a slime race as Gryffindor's talk about peaches. Sorry, that was me trying to be Gryffindor for a second. Oh wow, we have a lot of boys in the field. Lots of beans. I gotta stop saying boys because they're whatever gender their guardian wants them to be. So yeah, I will try to excise boys from my vocabulary, which is hard because I watch the McElroy brothers stuff, and so I've gotten very used to using the word boy. Thank you all for sticking around. It's nice to see so many beans in the field. There is a cube. Yeah, that's one of the forms that you can evolve into. Yeah, if you check out that evolution chart, I believe that is the first stage sturdy fruit evolution. Alright, I'll go ahead and do a 10 count, give people a chance to join this last slime race of the evening if they'd like a chance to win a fabulous thing. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright, starto! Alright, we are off to the races for this final race of the evening. We are supersonic racing, as the title of the song suggests. We'll let these little beans spread out a little bit before I start doing commentary. Okay, cool. We've got Halo and we've got Redacted. Redacted pushing ahead. Not sure why the name is Redacted. I guess Noodle Cat does things as slime is sort of a government secret. Halo pulling ahead as we get to the bottom of Blenny Hill. Still very much anyone's race. As we get to the second section of Slime Race Island, the treacherous waterfall suspension bridge. These low poly logs, edges are marked as sharp. Please be careful not to puncture any cytoplasm. There is a reason that water is green. Try to keep things drinkable around here. Well, I guess slimes might be drinkable. I've never tried eating one. I'd imagine they probably taste pretty good. Alright, Halo is a pretty decisive lead as we move on to Geyser Valley, but they will have a geyser to contend with. So we'll see if RNGesus is feeling good about Halo. Oh, I guess not. Might need to pray on that Halo. Falling asleep on a geyser. Woodchip getting pushed back. Alright, looks like Halo might be our winner. But Osai Rice and Woodchip might have a chance. RNGesus could float down on his mortar and pestle and just fuck up anybody's day. Oh, falling asleep right before the finish line. What an upset. Osai Rice and Wubchub pulling ahead of Halo with Nixie not too far behind. Redacted getting stunlocked. Critter getting stunlocked. Okay, cool. They have both. I nerfed the geysers a little bit, so hopefully we will get much fewer stunlocks. I do want them to happen sometimes, because it is funny. But I don't want it to happen all the time. Alright, Critter just finishing up. Redacted being a sleepy bean. Congratulations, Osiris. Very solid performance from both you and your guardian. Alright, Redacted dragging their ass across the finish line. No slime left behind. Let's go see. I forgot who won. I think it was Osiris, Wubchub, and Halo will be winning prizes. Let's go to the Results Island to see what those prizes are. Alright, congratulations to Osiris for winning the last race of the evening. They will get a gold feather in their cap. Very spiffy. Halo win a song. Little Mario World song. Wubchub will win. A Chrono Trigger song? I didn't know we had Chrono Trigger songs. Osiris will win a very special prize. Oh, they learned how to draw a little bonsai bill. Very nice. Congratulations to Osiris and their self-titled slime. Let me turn the music back on. Critter taking us to art school over there. More fish. Yeah, I agree. Very good job to Osiris as a little one. So yeah, I'm going to find somebody cool. Mixie drawing a little star. Love to see it. Oh, careful walking through Whisper over there. He gets very cold. Yeah, I'm going to find somebody cool for us to raid, but before I do that, I want to get my hand tracking, so it looks like I'm actually a living, breathing thing, even though my torso does not move whatsoever. Might have to work on that, but I want to thank you all so much for tuning in. This is a very fun stream. Thank you so much to Church for raiding us. Thank you for everyone in her crew that stuck around and played around with all this stuff that I've worked. Trying to avoid saying the word hard on, but I have worked a lot on this because every time I say the word hard on, it sounds T for teen. But anyway, I've worked a lot on this and I really appreciate each and every one of you that comes in to play around with it. and giving me ideas and just enjoying my work. It's very gratifying. Y'all make me very happy that I'm doing this weird internet puppet show. So I'm going to find somebody first to raid. I have a lot of really cool, talented friends. Oh, it's been amazing watching it come together. Thank you so much, Kisa Satoma. That means a lot coming from you. You're a very creative person in your own right. I was watching your stream earlier today. Always a good time. Let's see who we got here. Oh, yeah, we got Mordecai on. Yeah, I was watching Mordecai Devs earlier. Yeah, Mordecai Devs, for those that you don't...
freaking cool.
For those you don't know, is a very... Oh my god, I gotta put the avatar on the other side. Everybody does it on the right. But yeah, Mordecai Dev is another engine-based VTuber. I believe they use Unity. And they built their own, like, 3D streamer environment. And they have this really bitchin'-looking aesthetic that's, like... It reminds me a bit of Signalis. It's got this, like, low-poly kind of spooky look to it. And you know we like that here. So I'm gonna go ahead and send y'all to Mordecai Dev. Because they're always cooking up something really cool. Let's see. Shout out. Shout. Let it all out. These are the friends I can do with, not without, because I like them a lot. Okay, so I'm setting up the raid. And yeah, so stick around for that. If you have access, you'll get extra channel points, and if you have access to my emotes, go ahead and spam those. I am a few streams away from being able to do follower emotes, so hopefully I would like more people to be able to use them. But subscribers, you go ahead and go nuts, and people that aren't subscribed, don't worry, in a few more streams I got your back, and you'll be able to use the bouncy slimes and the hearts and all that stuff. So... Let's see. Looks like the raid is going to be ready soon. Stalling for time. Wait, did we raid? Oh, that was a shout out. Oh my god, I'm a fucking idiot. Okay. I'm a fucking idiot. Okay. There we go. Okay, so now I create the raid. So yeah, I really appreciate you guys. Especially now that I realize I'm a fucking idiot, but yeah, you're all very special to me, and I really appreciate all of you. I keep saying the same thing over and over again, so I'm gonna start that raid. So, go have a fun time. Bye, don't embarrass me.